Hello, you Burt Raccoon wannabes. Jim Sterling here, and this is Inferno Climber. It's in early access, and it's Dark Souls, basically. That's what it is. It's Dark Souls with a very PlayStation 1 era aesthetic to it. I know this because I recorded a video of this yesterday that you've not seen, because it just wasn't good. I recorded it at the end of the day. I was really tired and got like half an hour in and was just like, this is shit. So I stopped recording and I said, I'll do it tomorrow when I'm in a fresh mood. And that didn't quite work. You'll notice if you watch this immediately, as soon as it goes up, that this has gone up quite late in the day. And that's because I had a bad thing happen to me today, which we'll get into in a bit. This looks better than it did yesterday. Okay. All right, well, I'm actually glad that we didn't go with yesterday's video. Yesterday, I don't know if they've updated it or what, but the character models looked all jacked up. I'm sorry, I tried to suppress a little burpee there because I was drinking water before I recorded so that my throat would be moistened for your enjoyment. But just in case I forget to edit that failed suppression out, I'm sorry for that. I realise some people will just burp into a microphone. I try not to do that. I try and keep things a little classier here. So anyway, you'll immediately look at this and you should be able to recognize why I'm saying this is very Dark Souls-ish. We've got character classes here, which are basically Dark Souls classes. Young Warrior, Royal Knight with your high HP and defense. This is your balanced one. Forest Hunter, your bow user. Legendary Mage, your sorcerer. Renowned Priest, you got your cleric. Merchant, skilled at gathering items. You can see a whole bunch of items there. Innocent Prisoner with high strength. That's your bandit kind of class, I guess. Well, not a bandit, but very high attack. There is a Dark Souls analog. Can't remember what it is. And this will really seal the deal. Nothing noteworthy. There's your deprived right there. We're going to go with Royal Knight. Actually, we're just going to go balanced and easy to use because I don't feel like putting in any work today. That's fine. You are a young warrior. In the original video, I went with the knight, but we're going to go with a young warrior. You were born into an average family in a small town of a small kingdom. Loved by your parents, you lived in a peaceful, ordinary childhood. You get a different prologue bit here, depending on what background you choose. To protect your hometown, you learned how to use a sword, you're natural. Anyway, this is all story stuff. What happened today? I went for my physical therapy. If you're a regular viewer, you'll know that I've been dealing with a chronic back injury this year. I did something to it while engaging in ill-advised heavy lifting. And went for my physical therapy today, which is a lot of underwater stuff, doing various exercises in the water to try and get the muscles working. And I don't know what happened, but normally PT is an hour. I was 2 hours there because 1 hour was my normal physical therapy, and the second hour was them trying to fix whatever that day's physical therapy had done to me, without much success, unfortunately. I've done a lot of crying today. I don't mind telling you. I shall admit it. I've done a lot of open sobbing. It's been a rather pathetic state of affairs for your old pal Jim Sterling. I am still in tremendous pain right now as I do this. Not as bad. It's being dulled by my painkillers, which again, I may be a little low-key in my delivery, like I was with the inside video I did on Friday. I'm going to try and keep things fun and entertaining for you. If I do trail off and start talking complete bollocks, I apologize, but we will try and go at it. So, when I say, I mentioned the PlayStation 1 era at the beginning. When I say that, it's not to say the game, you know, looks as good slash bad as a PSX game. I mean, like, it's got the actual style of one. you know, graphics are better. A PlayStation 1 could not run this. Let's discard the hyperbole, but it looks like, you know, it belongs in that era from in terms of character design and level look and layout. You see what I mean? Hopefully you see what I mean. You talk to things, Sorcerer Sidon. They've entrusted their hope to us and they're sure that we can do some stuff. No response there. Now, yesterday I couldn't and I still can't work out how to make anything fucking run. I don't know if there's a sprint. There's a jump. There's an attack and a heavy attack. There's a shield. Well, we don't have a shield, but that's your block. And this is LT and LB have items. They recommend you use a controller, so a controller I'm using. I don't know if there's sprinting or not. I may be just too thick to work it out. But anyway, if you were still unsure of this game's Dark Souls inspiration, allow me to really confirm it for you, because we're about to fight... Well, we didn't even fight. Don't worry. That's supposed to... There we go. Dark Souls, isn't it? Life clouds your emotions. Death renders you naked. Dirty, naked, dead person. We're sinning. Many sins you've committed. Blah, blah, blah. Where will we go? Hell or heaven? Yesterday I clicked on hell because I decided I was edgy yesterday. Today I'm going to go with heaven. Because I don't know what, if any, difference that makes. Okay. So that's the difference. It makes us do this again. Hell starts the game properly then. Alright, we'll go with hell next time. So we're going to go fight the Dragon Lord again. And go through this whole rigmarole. Off we go. And... Yeah. Can I not? Can I? No. Can't. Alright. Alright. I'll sit through this again. No problem. Alright. Dragon Lord Daedalus. See, yesterday, I got this far and I did get a few attacks in before it actually got me. And there we go. My life's over. Game over. Excuse me, I'm just gonna readjust. I'm gonna be doing a lot of readjusting myself on this video. I'm sorry if that makes any, you know, if there's gonna be any bad microphone knocking or anything like that. Right, hell this time. What do weak men find beyond their shouts of anguish? I can grant temporary life to those who stand before me. It's just like Dark Souls, my friend. Again, sorry if you hear any microphone knocking. I'm going to have to reposition myself and reposition the microphone as I do, so... But I wanted to get some content up, you know? I wanted to get a video going, and I really wanted to cover this one because, as shameless as it is, and... Oh me, oh my, it's shameless as fuck, friends. I like it. I do find this one very... endearing. That's the nice word for it. Endearing. Sorry, I say that's the nice word. That sounds like I'm being very passive aggressive. What I mean to say is, from what I played yesterday, I liked it. So, anyway, here we are. Jumping. This is the whole tutorial bit. And the character goes, which I find very amusing. It amuses me. So, the contract. We've got to get Purgatory Stones. I struggled to say Purgatory Stone then. Gonna hit these boxes and get ourselves... Actually, I need to move that microphone because it's in the way of the fucking UI now on the screen. Right, so we need to equip things. So you hold the trigger, press Y to equip, and then we have ourselves a wooden rod. Aren't we lucky? All right, open this, take that, whatever it is. What is it, heal potion, fair dues. This world is different from yours. It wants new peace and order. So it's kind of like a dilapidated former kingdom. Huh. Where have I seen that before? Anyway, someone stole the Purgatory Stones from the king. Order collapsed. The land was thrown into chaos. Well, again, a little bit familiar. But I'm going to get this mushroom anyway. What y'all gonna do about it? Nothing. I bet we can go down there. I'm not gonna risk it. I didn't do that yesterday. What I'm gonna do is hit these pots and I get EXP and CP from it. So there we go. And I've got another mushroom. So Jim's winning. This is a side path. Only those with confidence should challenge it. Not recommended for amateurs. I did it yesterday and I got through it yesterday. So I'm gonna say I'm fairly confident. You watch me fuck it up now. Bloop, bloop. And another mushroom. God, we are the mushroom barons today, friends. Up here, up there. So we're going to see some combat. Click in the right stick, we target. And there we are. Smashed them with a rod. Three Zelda-esque jellies that we're fighting here. Now there is weapon durability. You see there, our wood rod is at 51%. Oh, hello. Cheeky bastard. Eep. Ah! Alright. Weapon is about to break. Fucking charming. There's a stamina meter because this game is just like Dark Souls. Hit that skeleton. Our weapon broke. So there's a skeleton archer up there. There we go. It's gonna take... It took most of my stamina to make that attack. But right, come on. Hit him before he hits us. There we go. Now... Also, I don't know how to dodge, if there is a dodge. Dun, dun, dun. We leveled up. Excellent. We won't be able to allocate skill points or anything like that yet, because, just like Dark Souls, we will reach a point where we can do that. So we got ourselves a shirt as a reward for taking our path. Let's, hang on. This UI is a little bit fiddly. Right. No. There we go. Traveler's shirt. What do I do with that? No. Equip. Right. That was me holding down a lot of buttons there. I think I didn't need to keep the LB held down. I don't need to touch LB a fucking tool. Look at that. I just go up and down. There we are. That's much better. Oh, Jim, you fucking cock. There you go. Now you know how to equip things. Right. With bare fists, we go in bravely. Oh, shit, that is one tough little jelly. There we go. Oh, and more pots. So some presents from there. All right. I like that it gives you an actual percentage marker to your next level. Is that a... No, it's just a little bit of wall that leads nowhere. Oh, look, it's a bonfire. Can you guess what we do at a bonfire, kids? We save at the bonfire! And we don't really want to quit. Because it will just quit you back to the menu screen. You don't give a fuck. Let's L trigger. Why? Equip. There we go. So, I've been out of commission most of today, as I'm sure you could understand with my being in so much pain that I was crying like a child. So, I was being drip-fed a lot of news today. And I was... I heard about the mini NES, the little NES that Nintendo brought out. And just over the course of the day, as the news was drip-fed, getting less and less interested in it. Right stick to look around, pressing view to default, gotcha. As I heard, oh, they're re-releasing the NES. I thought, that's weird, but cute. Why not? Then I hear, you know, it's got games packed in. So I'm like, oh, well, okay, that's interesting. Then I hear $60. Then I hear no internet capability and no way to add new games. So it is basically a Walgreens plug-and-play thing. $60 for 30 NES games, which many people will say is a good deal. Considering the virtual console alternatives are like five bucks a piece. That, of course, depends on whether or not you think that NES games are worth $5 anyway. which reminds me there is a certain Gymquisition topic I wanted to cover years ago and never got round to, and it might be the right time to do it this Monday. I'm not sure yet. I may be touching on that whole Shadow of Mordor, Warner Brothers, FTC thing. I don't know. Or I could do something completely different. I'm quite a whimsical young boy, so my mind could change. But we will see what happens. Anyway, the majority of lives in this world simply continue to repeat their assigned roles. Bit like Dark Souls. I'm going to stop saying that now. Rest assured that everything we say is very dark. I mean, even this whole tutorial type area is very Dark Souls-ish. Never went down there last time, and I'm not going to do it today. Not feeling that tasty. Let's get these little jelly bastards. Anyway, despite the fact that I am in pain and medicated, this is a much better video than yesterday's. Take it from me. Because, like I said, I had all the charisma of a fucking nail yesterday. Tired, annoyed, not in the mood for it. The video was incredibly forced. Oh, no. Hang on. There we are. That's the block. The right. Oh, didn't do anything. I guess you need a shield first, huh? Just using your forearm isn't a good way to defend yourself from a skeleton. That's what we've learned today. Dun dun dun. Leveled up. Now these little weird crystals, you hit them and they're like little platforms. Bloop. Ah, bloop. You can go up there like a platform. So that's fun. I wonder if we drown in there. I don't know how deep that is. I was going to sing How Deep Is Your Love then, and then I realised that would just be cringy, so I didn't. At least I've still got some mental wherewithal. So that's good. Right. The key is for this door up here. Yeah. Purgatory stones. We're not immortal. If we lose strength, heal our wounds with medicine. If we're hungry, we gotta eat. So there's a hunger thing as well. I'm not sure what that pertains to. Is it the little purple things? I think the red stuff is health. I don't know. Oh no! It's that thing that says 57%. Surely, because that's kind of a very, very stylized stomach, I suppose. The red shape behind the numbers. Hooray! So we are at half hungry. So let's, where's our food? Eat. There we are, 81%. And that is how you stop being hungry. Stop being a hungry boy. Review of everything up to now. XY attack, A jump, RS camera. RT use items, very important. Alright, so there's definitely nothing about a dodge. This is a teleporter. This brings us back to the starting area. Little bit of fast travel there. Not much, but a little bit. Nope. Yeah. Okay. It's something about that throws me. Because I hit B and I expect it to, you know, when you hit B on save, you expect the next thing to be like confirm a save. So I keep wanting to instinctively hit yes. Anyway, opens the menu. So that's good. There's a map there. Helps to have a map. I've not said that in a long while, have I? There's the world map. Good for us. Good for us indeed. What does this say? Hold the LT button to use items. We all know about that already. We worked that out for ourselves. There's a flame staff, would be useful if we were a sorcerer, but we're not, so I'm not going to go with it. Oh, fuck my goddamn horrible spine. Ah, there we are. Hold on, just twisting it left. Oh, trying to twist it right. There we go. Oh man, the longest 7 minutes of my life was getting out of the rehab center this morning. Like, I'm not joking, I was walking like I couldn't put a foot an inch in front of the other. And of course, being self-conscious as I am, I'm like, people are going to see this and think it's because I'm fat. It's like, it's not because I'm fat. It's not. I mean, okay, being fat probably didn't help my back, but it's a legitimate injury. Don't judge me. This is embarrassing. Because that was one of my chief concerns above the sheer fucking agony I was in. I was like, please don't judge me, I've lost 20 pounds. Which is true. I'm quite pleased with that. Good progress. Not nearly enough. But I'm good with it. The topic of that came up in the comments of yesterday's Pokemon Go video, because people could see my shadow and fat-shamed my shadow. which was, you know, fair enough. I was just Bone Man Soulstone. Well, there's the subtitle of today's video, Bone Man Soulstone. That's a great term. I might make that my new online handle for games. Pull that lever there. But yeah, people were very originally reminding me that I was fat, which was completely new news to me. Very shocking. And then someone called me sensitive because I humorously pointed out that people were stating the obvious by calling me fat. It's a fun comment thread. Anyway, talk about me old weight loss there, which is something I've been working on, and I've been pleased with how it's going, and I've been doing it for what I feel are the right reasons as well. Like, it's nothing to do with looks or anything like that. Like, you may find it hard to believe, but I don't mind how I look, and I do all right with the boys and girls. That, you know, it's not been a, that's it, yeah, fire and arrow, you fuck, thank you. You know, I do all right with attracting people that it's, again, you may find that hard to believe, that it's never been a concern of mine. But health-wise, you know, so these are all books and things. Read a book that we have. Dashing into tomorrow. Reading this gave me strength. It cured my swollen feet. It's let me run with my grandson. Oh, no, no. I keep, because B's confirm, not A here. There we are. It contains information about dashing. There we are. Hold down LS to dash and move faster than normal. Hooray! We can run. Oh, joyous, joyous day. Wonderful. Happy about that. Obviously, our stamina goes down right quick. But anyway, yeah, the whole point of the weight loss for me is just to do better, you know. Self-improvement. Not be dead when I'm 36, that'd be nice. Things like the back injury, less prone to happen as well, you know. It's been going well. I actually summoned the nerve to work with, you know, my doctor on this. Rather than just kind of ignore everything. And we're going to go through here. Anyway, that's enough about all that bollocks. Point is, I'm doing pretty well with it, and I'm pleased, and fuck anyone who's got a problem with that. One thing I'm not too happy about lately is the fact it's mosquito season. Mosquito season here in the American South, and I don't like it. I mean, the bugs love me, and I don't, I think because I've got horribly sensitive skin. Sorry, I knocked the microphone while looking at my wounds. Yeah, my back is, not my back, my skin. I'm going through my list of ailments. My arms are just chewed to pieces, and it's reacted really badly. I've been rubbing calamine lotion, Benadryl, like anything I can get my hands on all over myself. Anyway, purgatory stones. How long have I been doing this for? It feels like I've been going for ever. Right, stats. Oh yes, 5 levels, so we can put in, I'm guessing, 5 things. Nope, 4 things. All right, life force, bring our HP up. stamina. Gonna put two of them, and attack. Yeah, that's... I'm happy with that. Finalize these stats. I read that as fertilize. Fertilize these stats. What can we buy? We got our CP there. We could get a... We got a copper sword. We can get a helm. Let's get a helm. Yeah. I like the idea of that. What's this? Oh, that's our... We got a little storage thing. That's cool. Oh, shit. Clicked on the wrong thing. Oh, fuck. What did I do? What did I do? There we are. Not enough strength to equip. Balls. Oh, shit. Well, we've got a use for this now. Put in my helm. My useless helm, because I'm not strong enough. Serves me right for not paying attention. So this is as far as I got last time before giving up. Oh, we could change character. Change your characters might allow you to find new paths. If your characters die during their adventures, they cannot be selected. Huh. Interesting. That's it. So we sleep here. Recovered after a short rest. Oh, does that bring our hunger back up to normal? Well, our yeah, look, 100%. Apparently sleeping doesn't make you hungry. Insert, need a special magic stone. Magic stone, magic stone. Right, so where do we go from this shrine with a fire in it that seems to link the world, if you see what I'm getting at? Right, yeah, where the fuck are we going? Here, maybe? Let's go this way. Read this first. Chest contains sample food, feel free to take it. By the way, the Gate of Souls is ahead. Are those souls dark, perchance? I don't know. Alright. One plus side of, well, it's not really a plus side considering the game that I was playing, but I did get more free time to play through a lot of Technomancer today. Frankly, I'm not gonna... I don't know if I've got the mental energy to finish it before getting the review done, which some people find a controversial practice, but I've always been upfront about it. I don't necessarily hold that you need to necessarily see the credits before giving an opinion on a game. And my opinion of it is it bored me to fucking tears. Like, it's honestly, it's all right as a game, but so much back and forth through the same areas, backwards and forwards, the same enemies over and over and over again. Fucking hate it. I'm gonna sit back now. That's my next position, hold up. All right, there we go. There we are. But yeah, I've spent hours upon hours with the Technomancer today. On top of the hours I've already spent. That microphone might be in a bad position there. There we are. A professional would cut out all the fiddly bits, but I'm going to be unprofessional, but I'm going to sell it to you as you getting the raw, unplugged Jim Sterling. I don't dress it up. See me as I am. Love me as you leave me. I don't know what any of what I just said meant. Right. Okay, that's good. I was wondering if it took stamina to jump. I hate games that take stamina to jump. I guess we'll need to read a book to learn how to dodge at some point. Maybe. Where are we going? You gonna open up? No purgatory stone. Oh, this is the whole purgatory stone shit. Well, ball sacking it. All right. Now I will cut stuff, because I'm going to have to go all the way back. So I will resume the video when I know where we're going. Okay, we're in the Poison Forest. That's what the sign outside said. Feels a little early in the game to be going to this game's version of Blighttown, but here we go. A door seems to have opened. Yeah, the one we just saw open, probably. Okay, well... If indeed we have gone... Because I don't know if there are any other paths. I did a run round the... I'm just going to call it Firelink Shrine. But this was the most obvious route to take. Anyway, forest controlled by monsters, immense power deep inside the forest, warm hospitality awaiting intruders. All right. Now, can we pick that up? Yeah. You can use the wood rod on these fires, very Zelda-ish, and you can light them on fire and make a little torch for yourself. Well, enemies are pretty standard so far, nothing new. So I'm going to assume we are going the right way, and we're not going somewhere we're not leveled up enough for. Whoa! What you doing? Some of that, you bastard. What's that? Oh. Huh. Okay. I guess we'll go and activate that over yonder. Ugh. Okay, don't fall in the purple gloop. Ah! Ha ha! Leveled up. I leveled up my strength again in the bit that you won't see. Because we got that other level up while I was on my way to that purgatory area. Not strong enough yet to equip the helm. I put more in my strength stat. So I'm going to pump it into strength till I can wear that helm so I haven't wasted my fucking money. Can we cut the grass? Nah. Whoa. Who's firing at me? Whoa! Bone Man Lewis. Fuck you, Bone Man. And Morrison. Come here. Actually, didn't notice. I mean, that tells you just how distracted you can be when you're trying to play a game and talk at the same time. Didn't notice that when you locked on, you got names of the monsters. Like a fucking, like, old beat-em-up game. I like it, though. It's cute. Martinez. Oh. Yeah. Counter. Some of that, Martinez. Whee. Whoa! Big old fish. Can't target it. I guess, oh no, I guess they're just window dressing at that point. With a bow, I can attack distant enemies. I need to equip both a bow and arrows. I just need to learn how to shoot it from someone. There's a room underground for that. Ah, so you need to... Oh. Leveled up just from picking up a bow. How nice. Oh! Here's to you, Bone Man Robinson. Oh, that's good as well. Because that skeleton was called Robinson, and then I said, here's to you, Bone Man Robinson, instead of Mrs. Maybe that will be the subtitle of the video. And then people who get to this point will realize that what I said earlier about the subtitle is different because of what I did now. I don't know what I'm talking about right now. Repair one item. I want to repair my sword. There we go. Keep it in tip-top condition. Okay, so presumably we need to go get a book and read it in that area for the bow and arrow. How to learn bow... Sorry. I'm at that point now where my ability to talk has gone. That's fine. It's fine. I've got to do a podcast after this as well. I'm doing spin-off Doctors with Conrad, talking about the Silent Hill movie, which we had to postpone. It was supposed to be straight after Physical Therapy Today, but obviously shit happened. All right, well, our inventory's full. I'm going to get us to the next save point and open it from here. Seems to be a switch above the door. Maybe if I can throw something. How do we... Okay. We target? Can't target. What can we throw? Let's throw a wooden rod. We got enough of those. So, left trigger, throw, well that went well, ah, okay, so we've got to hold it, let's get into a good position, hold it, I didn't see the line then, and I figured I messed it up. Hold on. We'll try that again. And whoa! This may take us some time. Okay. I'm aiming with the bow and arrow. Instead. Fire! Aha! There we go. Look at that. We didn't need to read the book to learn. But I am gonna release that. Because I didn't want to be a ranged character. Much better off with my starter sword. There we are. Equip. It took me a moment to figure that out. Remember. The whole equipment process. The poison here is terrible. Drain my strength. Having resistance to poison would be good. Okay. Well, we don't got resistance to poison, so let's dash up here and hope we don't fall down. Ugh. What the fuck? Whoa. Okay. There we are. I was trying to be extra careful and not fall. Oh, fuck. Where did you come from? There's loads of them now, the bone men. Oh, triple bone man kill. All right, we're gonna have to be super duper careful, kids. That was just adorable. Okay, good job it warns us. Let's eat that now. Left trigger, eat. Om nom 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 nom. Om nom 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 nom. Eat more mushrooms all the time. Holy shit, it takes stamina to eat mushroom? Huh, I guess. And vloop. No save point yet. My device started moving. Oh. Oh, we can cook meat. Oh. No, oh, we need flame fruit and stuff. Oh, there's flame fruit right here. Aha! Now we're gonna go cook him. Yes. Let's cook a mushroom. All right, so now we have cooked food. Got a storage thing there. More mushrooms. I'm not gonna bother picking those mushrooms up, actually. Because we were already running out of inventory space. I've got a bone. I got a bone, look. I'm not gonna hit with the bone. Okay, where are we going? God, I really need a bonfire soon because I am fading fast. Oh shit. Okay, that went okay. Oh, I don't like all the shuddering. It's not good. Ah, oh, fuck. Run away. There we go. Not enough SP. God dang it. Demon dropping eye Ashley. I wonder what the story is with the names. Come here. Fucking Ashley. I leveled up. What you gonna do about it? What you gonna do? Okay, God, can there be a bonfire soon? I really do need a resty poo. Where are we at? Because normally I would just abandon it, but I kind of like this game and don't wanna. I don't know. I'm gonna have to stop the video anyway, because I'm clearly fading and not being entertaining anymore. Sorry about that. Hope you enjoyed the video anyway. I do like this game, even though it's blatantly Dark Souls. I'm all right with that. Just because it's fun. It's fun and it's got a cute, silly look to it. It's an early access right now, and for an early access game, clearly robust, which I always like to see. So I'm going to leave you now, and I'll see you later. Bye.